This is a demonstration of a continuously variable transmission, a belt-driven continuously variable transmission. This is a General Motors VT25 transaxle. It has a drive pulley right here and a driven pulley over here. It has a steel belt that seems to be the weak point in these transmissions, because the steel belts tend to break at times. We have an input shaft from the torque converter that's connected to the engine, so our power comes in. We have a reverse clutch that if we held this solid with the engine turning, the drive pulley would turn backwards. We have a forward clutch that when it applies with the engine turning, will connect the forward clutch to the drive pulley and turn the drive pulley, causing the driven pulley over here to also rotate. Connected to the driven pulley is our output shaft with this gear right here. This gear connects to the final drive and propels the front tires. So the way a CVT, which is continuously variable transmission, the way that works is to continuously vary the gear ratio of the input to the output. The gear ratio in the low range that we're in right now is about 2.6 to 1. It takes about 2.6 turns of the input shaft to equal one turn of the output shaft. But we can control the width of this pulley and the width of this other pulley, which makes the steel belt shift positions, and we can have gear ratios that go anywhere from that 2.6 to 1 all the way up to an overdrive gear ratio of clear up to about 0.4 to 1, which I'll demonstrate here in just a moment. So we're going to have power coming in. If we want to move forward, we apply the forward clutch and turn the drive pulley. In this demonstration, we're actually going to hook a socket to the output and turn the driven pulley, but that's not really how it's done in the vehicle. But we're doing that in this demonstration to show you the different gear ratios as we change it with compressed air on the pistons that are in these housing. So we've got a very large socket and a drill motor we're going to hook up to the driven pulley. Let's go ahead and start turning that. Notice that as the drive pulley turns very quickly, the driven pulley is turning very slowly, and it's a gear ratio of about 2.6 to 1. Now, if I come in and want to change the gear ratio, I'm going to apply hydraulic pressure to the piston that controls this pulley, and I'm going to use air pressure in this demonstration, and it's going to be noisy, but you'll see the pulley come down to a smaller width, and it's going to cause the driven pulley to go wider. So I'm going to do that right now. So notice now the input is turning really slow, where the output is turning fast. That's an overdrive position. So we're in overdrive right now. The engine's turning really slow, but the output shaft is turning really fast. Now we're going to come in and change the ratio back to an underdrive situation. So now we've got the engine turning really fast and the wheels, or the output, turning really slow. And that's those are the two extremes of a CVT transmission. And what's cool is that we can vary the gear ratio anywhere between this low and the high that we had. We can even have a one-to-one gear ratio of direct drive. So once again, this is a continuously variable transaxle, CVT, and this particular one is out of a General Motors product, a Saturn, but Honda, Nissan, Chrysler all use continuously variable belt-driven transmissions, transaxles. The hybrid electric vehicles use an electronic continuously variable transaxle that uses electric motors and a planetary gear set in place of these pulleys.